The Kraft Music Hall with Bing Crosby, John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Marilyn Maxwell, the Music Maids and Men, Yuki, the Charioteers, and Bing's guest this evening, Paramount's big new star, Mr. Sonny Tufts. And here's Bing Crosby.
How would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a mule? A mule is an animal with long, funny ears, kicks up at anything he hears.
His back is brawny and his brain is weak. He's just plain stupid with a stubborn streak.
And by the way, if you hate to go to school, you may grow up to be a mule.
Or would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Rude.
Or would you rather be a pig?
A pig is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace. He has no manners when he eats his food.
He's fat and lazy and extremely rude.
But if you don't care a feather or a fig, you may grow up to be a pig.
Or would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are, rude?
Or would you rather be a fish?
A fish won't do anything but swim in a brook. He can't write his name or read a book. To fool the people is his only thought.
And though he's slippery, that catfish still gets caught.
But then if that sort of life is what you wish, you may grow up to be a fish. You kind of jumped up slippery fish, and all the monkeys are in the zoo.
Every day you meet quite a few.
So you see, it's all up to you. You can be better than you are. You can be swinging on a star.
This is the Old Kraft Music Hall, friends, slated for many a battle station where they're making tomorrow's headlines, making them the hard way. Our papers carry encouraging news, news that inclines the over-optimistic to figure we can ease off. But at this juncture, to slack up can only mean to back up, and we can't back up until they crack up. Now is surely no time to relax. Making your opponent hit the canvas isn't enough. You got to make him take the count. It's the only way to win.
Gee, won't it be wonderful, Bing, when everything is over and there's peace again? And we can be really happy, go on vacations in the country. Do you like flowers?
Not too much.
Honestly?
Yeah.
Gosh, when I see flowers growing, I just want to fill my arms with them and hold them close to me.
Plant me now and dig me later.
Say, Bing.
Dig me quite a bit later, yes.
Well, you say things like that only because I'm a nobody. But does anybody know why I'm a nobody?
Make a double line, folks, right up through here.
No, what I mean is, you know, it's easy to identify other celebrities because they have titles.
Yeah.
Like, people know you as the Groner.
Yeah.
Sinatra, the voice.
Voice.
Monty Woolley's the beard.
Mm-hmm.
Rita Hayworth's the face.
Got a name for you.
What?
The puss.
Please, Bing, figure it out. How long have I been hanging around the hall here?
Well, let's see. 2, 3, 4 goes into 5, 6. I got it figured.
How long?
Too long.
See what I mean? Now, how would you feel if you went to the same place every week for 2 years and nobody paid any attention to you?
Happens to me.
Where?
My ration board. No.
Well,
tumble.
the reason people don't notice me is because I haven't got a theme song.
I got one for you.
You really have?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what?
It could happen to you.
It could, huh?
That'd be nice.
Well, you know, when I get a theme song that people
small
would recognize...
Souffle, I didn't do that one.
You see, if I got a theme song that people would recognize, as soon as they'd hear it, click would go their minds, and then I'd start to talk.
Click, off would go their radio.
I think Yuki has a point, Bing. Sometimes I wish I had a theme song.
What's the matter with that song, All That Meat and No Potatoes?
Look, I have a few ideas on a theme song for myself. Maybe you can help me decide. Huh?
Hit me.
How about, looky, 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 here comes Yuki.
Try again.
All right. How's this? He's right on the beam with plenty of steam.
No, you're pressing.
How about he will drive your blues away. He will make your heart feel gay. He will make you cheer and wave. You all know him.
Burma Shave. Well, it had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around, finally found that somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue, and even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be me, might never be cross or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do for nobody else. Gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still, 'cause it had to be you. Wonderful you. Had to be you. For nobody else gave me a thrill. That's your fault, but I love you still. Well, it had to be you. Wonderful you. Had to be you.
Before turning to that fine group, the Charioteers, we make way for my friend from the sales department.
You ladies will agree it takes skill and experience to prepare a first-rate meal. But there's one part of the meal anyone can prepare perfectly, and that's the salad. All you need are well-chilled, well-washed salad greens, fruit or vegetables, and Miracle Whip salad dressing. You know, it's really not exaggerating to say that Miracle Whip assures a successful salad. For the flavor of the dressing is the flavor that makes the salad. And Miracle Whip is the salad dressing millions prefer. There's a special come-on to the flavor of Miracle Whip that appeals to both men and women, and children love it, too. No other dressing has it, for Miracle Whip is made by an exclusive recipe. It combines the qualities of zesty boiled dressing and fine mayonnaise. Try it soon.
Oh, that's beautiful music.
Yes, it is.
Sounds like a strain from Bach.
Just how far, Bach?
Man, that's way Bach.
Oh, Columbus had more chance than me.
When was that?
In 1492, when he sailed across the sea.
At least.
He thought he knew just what he was doing.
But you've been in a fog all your life.
And I'm in search of something to.
You don't know what you're doing either.
Exactly what I wish I knew. Yes, I pursue. But who am I pursuing?
Reluctant dragon.
Chances are that I won't find a bride.
Not with that wolfish look in your eye.
But it's not because I haven't tried.
Come out wherever you are. I know you're not very
not so very far.
I wish you'd hurry, 'cause I'm inclined to worry.
Those arms of mine are open,
hoping that you'll appear. Why can't you hear me, dear? Come out, mop, mop, wherever you are. Come out from under that star. And incidentally,
medley,
I'm not up to par, so come out, come out, come out, wherever you are, wherever you are.
Back in the old craft music hall for a couple of quick retakes is my friend and my colleague over at Paramount, Mr. Sonny Tufts. Currently being co-starred with Paulette Goddard in I Love a Soldier, Sonny's just finished another service job to which I, too, have had the honor of contributing my questionable talents. I'm speaking of an item called Here Come the Waves. Speaking of waves, this Sunday, that fine organization celebrates its second anniversary. Congratulations, gals. Of course, to all you chicks who are still not in the waves, the second anniversary presents your big anniversary opportunity to join up absolutely free. No down payments, no interest to pay, no carry-in charges. You just walk into your nearest Navy recruiting office and you say, I want to join the Navy. Think it over, gals. It's a dynamite outfit, isn't it, Sonny?
Yeah, Bing, you know, I find the waves a very attractive organization.
Just how would you describe the average wave, Sonny?
Well, a sailor who says no.
You know, you two guys must have had a tough time on that picture. Tell us about it.
Well, Ken, you see, in the first place, here come the waves.
Yeah?
There goes Crosby.
Well, you make Bing sound like a wolf.
Well, you know, when hope's away, I got to...
That hope's a swell guy. Well, he even offered me a job in his radio show selling toothbrushes.
Singing?
No, just being one of the 50 Tufts.
Give me the brush, Ken.
I suppose you two are doing something handsome to celebrate the Wave's second anniversary.
Only got our own recruiting drive.
No.
That's all.
Oh, this just I've got to
come
see.
Come over, come closer, we'll lay it on you.
A busy... I'll do that. It's a busy intersection, Hollywood and Vine. A new Wave recruiting booth featuring Sonny Tufts, A.S., that's apprentice seaman, and Bing Crosby, A.S.S., apprentice seaman substitute. Crowds passing the booth are held spellbound by the soothing, dulcet tones of Crosby as he lulls them with his subtle charm and his quiet, compelling, heart-to-heart talk.
Come over, come over, come over right here. Get your wave applications right here. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get away from me, boys. You bother me. A little closer, girls. I'll bother you. Hurry, 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 hurry. Sign up today. Take home a battleship absolutely free.
I don't see any battleship.
It's tattooed in his chest.
Hurry, 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 hurry. Sign up here for the waves. Come over.
You're not
come
doing
over.
So good, Cross. You better let me try. Gee, I signed up 10 last night.
What's your technique?
Well, there's no technique. I just walk up to a pretty girl and sort of smile at her, and then she sort of smiles at me, and I smile again, and she smiles at me, and we talk, and pretty soon, another wave.
I tried that. Another wave goodbye.
Well, why don't you do what I said, Cross? Okay. I mean, there's one place I know we can sign up all the girls we need, just like that.
Oh, no, no, I won't go there. I will not go there. I swear, I don't care what you say,
it's
you're
the
not
only
going
place to
no,
find plenty
never.
Of girls.
I,
girls
I
by the hundred.
No, you can whip me, you can lash
okay.
me, you can kill me, but I'm not going there.
Okay. We'll find plenty of recruits at a Sinatra broadcast.
This recruiting detail is that's a stale thing for me anyway. I'm a sailor. I'm a sailor, boy. Give me a schooner. Cutting through the foam.
High seas?
Short beers.
Hey, you sailors. Where's the other guy that used to be in this booth?
Why?
Well, a year ago, he talked my wife into joining the waves. Now, I haven't seen her since.
What do you want to see him about?
I just want to shake his hand.
Hey, let's get some action around here. What do you say? Any of you fellows know any girls we can recruit?
Well, I'll send my cousin over. She works in an office.
Good. The Navy needs stenographers.
I'll send over my girlfriend. She's a wonderful cook.
Good. The Navy needs cooks.
I'm John Scott Trotter, and I'd like to send over my twin sister.
Good. The Navy
She's
needs...
She's exactly like me.
Sorry. Good. The Navy needs landing barges.
Say, what do you say? Shall I send my girlfriend around?
Listen, buddy. You give us your name, we'll sign you up for the Navy.
Okay, you can put it down. My name is Yuki.
Fine. From now on, you'll be known as the USS Yuki.
United States Seaman?
You sad sack.
ships.
Say, excuse me, you sure see a lot of different ranks of servicemen around here. What's that big guy's over there?
Yeoman.
Yep. What about that other guy, the one whose head goes up and down every time he sees a girl walk by?
Yo-Yeoman.
Pretty funny.
Loaded tonight.
You know, I think the biggest part of you sailors is conceit.
How come?
Well, most of them are too big for their britches.
That's not conceit. That's deceit.
Maybe. Get the onblay all day, heaving to on the ort pay, I'd say. Some Iggins ray. Aye, aye, aye.
Hello?
Stand aside, men. The Navy's about to go into action.
Could you explain to me how I might become a wave? I mean, tell me all about it.
Oh, I'd be glad to.
Not you, the big one.
You know, you look like excellent material for a petty officer.
Or a petty drawing.
It's every young lady's duty, really, to join the Navy and see the world.
But I always thought a woman's place was in the home.
Okay, race you home.
Well, if I were interested in joining, do you think I could fill out the form?
Well, you did all right by the one you got.
Well, what kind of a uniform would I wear?
Oxford's, black, slightly grained, but très chic. Of course, no suede. Beige hose and the chambray shirt is just a dream. Your delightful dungarees will have a natty little matching jacket. All in all, the whole ensemble is just sheer heaven.
Well, how do you know all this?
I make my own clothes.
They look it.
Well, if I join the Navy, will I go to sea?
If you join the Navy will go to sea. S-double-E-E-E-E-E-E.
Tell them more about that, Crowd.
Well, it's,
Ankles away, my boy.
Nylons ahoy, boy.
On all the seven seas,
you rule the waves.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh. Ankles away, we say, we'll win.
When we come home to stay,
we'll let the waves against that ruling us. We'll let the waves against that ruling us. Waves against that ruling us. Waves against that ruling us.
Time marches back. 1928. Henry Ford unveils his new Model A. And C.C. Cash and Carry Pyle starts Bunyan Derby from Los Angeles to New York. 1928. The boom is at its peak. Stocks reach new highs and women's skirts reach new thighs. 1928. Gangsterism and prohibition make a mockery of law and order. 1928. And many a young man living the pace that kills is whispering thoughtfully to his fiancée.
You know, honey, I've been thinking.
Really?
Well, you needn't be that surprised.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Harry. What have you been thinking about?
Well, I ain't getting any younger, and when a guy starts getting to be my age, well, he begins to think about the things he really wants.
Things like what, Harry?
Well, I'm looking forward to a pipe and a pair of slippers, a comfy smoking jacket, and something, well, maybe something else, just to make it all complete.
What else, Harry?
Oh, use your own judgment. I've given you enough hints. Next week's my birthday.
I may not even see you that day.
Oh, now you sound sore. Gee, I don't understand you dames at all.
I guess you really don't, do you, Harry?
I guess not.
Oh, well. Some of the kids are going canoeing tonight. They want us to go with them.
Oh, boy. Remember the last evening we went canoeing?
Uh-huh.
Not going to make you paddle this time.
Oh, thank goodness.
Got an outboard motor. Everybody rides, nobody paddles. A little noisy, gas, maybe, you know.
Gee, Harry, it'll be beautiful on the lake. Just you and me and the moon shining across the water.
Could we get a canoe just for two? Alone?
We could if you wanted.
And we could we lose that mob? You know how they are with their ukuleles and everything. Hanukkah, you were wiki wiki. Wiki wiki. What's it on the Ralphs and all that? Sort of get off by ourselves where it's nice and quiet.
Oh, let's plan to get off by ourselves,
oh,
Harry.
Oh, great. I'll bring my fishing tackle.
Harry.
Yeah?
Have you heard that new song that goes, mean to me? Why must you be mean to me?
Who's mean to you? I was planning on giving you half of everything I caught. Give you anything. You're the cream in my coffee. You're the salt in my stew. You will always be my necessity. I'd be lost without you.
Would you really, Harry?
We stroll the lane together.
At the rain together,
sang love's refrain together,
and we'd both pretend it would never end. One day we'd cry together,
cast love aside together. You're gone from me, but in my memory we always will be together. Together,
laughed at the rain together,
sang love's refrain together, and we both pretend it would never end.
One day we cry together.
Love aside together. You're gone from me, but in my memory we always will be
of the important items of 1928, we turn to some of the important things of 1944.
During the past few years, you homemakers have gained much new knowledge in the field of nutrition. You know the importance of vitamins and minerals and the so-called protective foods which supply them. Salads, of course, are among the finest protective foods, and salads served with Miracle Whip are downright delicious eating. Just on plain lettuce or other greens, that lively Miracle Whip flavor is a treat. And how grand it tastes on Victory Garden tomatoes, how perfect it is with fruits. A unique combination of zestful old-fashioned boiled dressing and fine mayonnaise, Miracle Whip has a very special flavor all its own. It's not too bland or oily, not too sharp either. It's just exactly right. There's pleasure for you, too, in Miracle Whip's creamy smoothness, a pleasure only this one dressing can give. For Miracle Whip is mixed in a remarkable beater that's used exclusively by Kraft. The next time you shop, include a jar of Miracle Whip salad dressing in your order. If your food dealer happens to be out of it, please be patient and wait until he gets a new supply. Because of wartime restrictions, Miracle Whip cannot be made in sufficient quantity to take care of the demand for it. This demand is great, you know, because Miracle Whip is America's favorite salad dressing.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places.
that this heart of mine embraces all day through. In that small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut tree, the wishing well, I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be
That gets us through another Thursday in the Old Craft Music Hall, but there are more Thursdays to come, and on each of them, another meeting of the Craft Music Hall group. Next week, for example, we'll once more feature such outstanding talent as the Charioteers, John Scott Trotter in his Titanic 26, the Music Maids and Men, Yuki, my friend and colleague, Mr. Sonny Tufts, and such outstanding guests as Lena Romay and that big hat man from Sardis, Tom Brenneman. Sounds like a very colorful assemblage, well worth a half hour of anybody's time. Try and catch it. Good night.
Tune in to Craft Music Hall next Thursday at this same time to hear Sonny Tufts, John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Music Maids and Men, Yuki, the Charioteers, and our special guests for the evening, Lena Romay and Tom Brenneman. Marilyn Maxwell appeared through the courtesy of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, the producers of the Technicolor musical Bathing Beauty.
Victory Garden salads and cold meat cuts are lunchtime favorites these hot summer days, so serve them this extra tempting way, flavored with the taste-tingling tang of Kraft-prepared mustards. Golden, creamy, smooth Kraft salad mustard is just what's needed to pep up your salad dressings. And to make those cold cuts extra inviting, spread on that nippier Kraft mustard with horseradish added. Buy both varieties, Kraft horseradish mustard and Kraft salad mustard. Remember to put Kraft mustards on your shopping list tomorrow.
This is the National Broadcasting Company.